really quick, nice, flowing Pilates series to help you stretch out, de-stress your body and your mind. See you on the mat. To start today, you're just going to grab your legs and roll yourself down to your mat. We're going to start with some arm circles to warm up the shoulders and activate the abs. Inhale as you reach overhead without letting the ribs lift. Exhale, circle the arms around beside you. Inhale, lift. Exhale, circle, holding neutral the whole time so you don't want to jam into the back of the glutes or the hips. Inhale, exhale, circle. Inhale, reach. Exhale, circle. Then we're just going to go the other way. Press straight down to the hips. Reach the arms for the walls and over your head. Exhale, circle. Every time you breathe out, I want you to feel that corset tightening. Okay, and then just bring the arms right down beside you. We're going to go right away into hip rolls. So going through that imprint, you're going to scoop into the waist, squeeze into your glutes, and round up into your bridge. If you'll make it harder, take the arms over your chest. Exhale, roll down slowly through your spine. Inhale here, exhale, engage the abs and scoop to roll up. Feel like you're squeezing a little ball between the knees so the legs don't flop to the side. Inhale here, exhale, roll it down slowly, slowly, slowly. Good, take an inhale to stay. Find the shoulder blades actively working on the back of the ribs. Breathe out, squeezing into your glutes. Feel like nothing in the low back. You're gonna hold it here. Just for three deep breaths, inhale, stay. Exhale, work into the back of the hip a little deeper. Keep the ribs closed. Inhale, stay. Exhale, squeeze your imaginary ball. Inhale, hold. Exhale, roll down slowly through your spine all the way to the mat. You can take your arms down at any point if it gets a little hard. Exhale, go into that same imprint. Start to roll up to your bridge. Inhale at the top, exhale, stay. Check that your shoulders aren't lifting to your ears. And hold, push into the instep of your foot a little bit. It helps activate your inner thighs a little deeper. And roll down slowly, slowly, slowly. Tuck your knees in and just give them a little hug. We're gonna go roll over onto your side and go into our spinal rotation. Now, if you need a pillow, you can use one from your couch. I'm gonna use my yoga brick. Just stacking your shoulders, knees, and feet right over top of each other. You're gonna peel the top arm up. Feel like you're painting on the ceiling with your hand as you spiral to the back. Inhale, stay. Exhale, use your abdominals to round you back over. Inhale, reach that top arm up. Exhale and just rotate. Inhale, stay. Exhale, use your abs to pull your body right back over top, keeping the shoulders away from the ears. Exhale, rotate. Inhale, stay. Use your abs to pull you back over top. One more. Inhale, reach up to the ceiling. Exhale as you rotate. Inhale to stay. Exhale, round yourself back over. Good. I'm just going to roll over to the second side. Stack your arms right on top of each other, keeping the shoulders connected at the back. Inhale, reach that top arm up. Exhale, rotate. Doesn't matter how far you go, let your head go with your upper body. Breathe out and bring the rib cage and the arm back over top. Feel like your hand is going to touch the ceiling the whole time. Inhale here. Exhale, use your abs to round you back over. Two more. Reach that top arm up to the ceiling as you breathe out. Breathe in here. Activate those abs. Roll yourself back over. Last one. Inhale, reach up to the ceiling. Exhale as you rotate. Inhale here, exhale, bring that arm right back over. Good, from there, just come up onto your hands and knees. And we're gonna go into some cat stretches. So, hands are just underneath your shoulders, knees are under the hips. rounding up into your angry cat. And uncurl tailbone to head back out into your extension. And scoop to round. Feel your belly button lift. Uncurl from your tailbone to your head. Feel like you're pulling your ribs through your arms so you don't collapse down. One more. Exhale, scoop to curl. And uncurl right back out into extension. From here, just come back to your neutral. We're going to go into your swimming preps. You want to activate your abdominals. You're going to reach your right leg away from you. At the same time, reach the left arm to the front wall. Inhale, bring it back down. Exhale, reach the left arm and the right leg. Now, the goal of this is to not tilt or tip. And maintain that deep connection through the waistline and through the spine. So your back muscles are working to support you and your abdominals are stopping you from tilting. Exhale, reach. It's a good strength builder. Exhale, reach. And fold. Don't worry how high your leg goes. If it stays on the floor, that's fine. If you can't move the leg, just do the arms. Or vice versa, you could just do the legs with this. And fold. We're gonna do arms and legs today though. And fold. Last one, reach. And fold. Just rock back into a little shell stretch. Good. And then just come up to sitting. You're going to stretch your legs straight out in front of you. You're going to go into your spine twist, your rotation. Take the arms out to the walls. Shoulders are away from your ears. And we're just going to feel that upward lift as you rotate. Bending the back arm, you're going to exhale, press for three. Get taller, feel your waistline pulling in, and back, feel that corset feeling. Inhale straight, exhale, press three, two, one. Inhale straight, exhale, press three, two, one. Inhale straight, two more, reach, two, three. Don't worry about how far you rotate, feel about the lift and the engagement through the waistline. And going right to your saw, you're going to rotate, turn the back arm out, round forward from under the ribs, and just saw across your ankle for three little pulses. Round it back up. Rotate. Use your abs to fold you forward. Shoulders away. And roll it back up. Rotate. We're going to do two more each side. And round three. Use those abs. Two and one. Reach out through the back arm. Rotate. And round for three. Two, one, round it up, last set, rotate, press, three, breathing out, two, one, and reach it up, last one, rotate and press for three, two, one, and round it up. So that one's great because it works into the waist and also stretches your back. We're going to go into rolling like a ball, so bringing your feet together. I'm going to do it together. You could do this turned out. Traditional way is under the heels. You're going to do it with the knees touching and the hands on the side of your calves. Rock just off your sit bones. Find your C shape. Eye line is down to your knees. You're going to lift your toes off and find your balance. You don't want the space from your heel to your hips to change or knees to shoulders, so you shouldn't be kicking in this one. From here, round yourself back as you inhale. Breathe out. Use the abs to round you back up. Inhale back. Inhale here. Keep your eye line to your knees. If you go back and you lift your head, you're going to go flat and you'll go thump. And we call it rolling like a stump because you won't come back up. Inhale, round it back. Two more here. It's a good one. It works the waistline and it massages through your whole back as you roll. And then just roll yourself right back up. Good. From here, just turn to face front. We're going to go into a little mermaid stretch. It's one of my favorite ones. Reach the left arm up. We're going to round over to the right as you breathe out. Just hold it there and breathe. From there, you're going to add a rotation so you're going to dome through the ribs like our cat stretch and rotate towards your right knee. Don't force it. Just go to where it feels good. You should get a stretch down the left side of the rib cage. Rotate back to the center and round yourself up. Right arm goes up, lengthen over to the left side. And just breathe. Then add that rotation towards the left knee. Same scoop through the waist. And rotate back to the front. And just round yourself all the way back up. Thanks so much for joining me again today. I hope you're feeling centered and relaxed after that little workout. As always, please leave any of your comments and questions below. If you like this video, please be sure to like it and share it with your friends. I hope you have a great day today, and I'll see you back here tomorrow for day number 14.